everybody, this is Rayhan World Travels, and today I am in Istanbul, one of the biggest cities in the world and the only big city that actually straddles two continents. And so it's supposed to be a foodie's paradise, and everything I've seen and heard about it, it just looks amazing. It's a bit cold and rainy. It's towards the end of December, 2 days till Christmas, but should be amazing. Okay, so this is the Blue Mosque in Istanbul, and it goes up pretty high. It's one of the most amazing mosques in Istanbul, and it was built in the early 1600s. And the reason it's called the Blue Mosque is because the interior is mainly blue, and the reason for this is turquoise is actually a color from Turkey, so that's why they call it turquoise. Stepped out of the Blue Mosque, and right outside is the Arasta Bazaar, and it's selling all type of things from mosaics to jewelry. And Istanbul is basically known for its bazaar, so it only makes sense if there's one right outside the Blue Mosque. And the bazaar. So now we're walking to the Hagia Sophia. That was previously a church, then it was a mosque, and now it's a museum. We are now in the Hagia Sophia. Built in 500 AD, it was originally the largest church in the world until the Cathedral of Sevilla was built. And in the 1400s or 1500s, the Ottomans took control of Turkey and they converted this into a mosque. It is now a museum. That's the Galata Tower. It's a quaint neighborhood with a bunch of shops and little streets and stuff. And if you look that way, you can see the Asian side of Istanbul. Thank you. heard of it after recent protests. Over there is the Republic Monument. And it's Christmas time, and this is beautifully decorated. There's also a tram over there that takes you down Independence Avenue. Schedule as it is day two of Istanbul. Right now we're at Topkapi Palace. After that we're going to the Spice Bazaar, Grand Bazaar, and lots more. So this is Topkapi Palace, which was home to the Ottoman Empire for over 400 years until the collapse in World War I. And we're standing in the largest courtyard of them all, and there are a lot of them. We're supposed to go inside the harem rooms, which is their private quarters, home to the sultan, his wives, his mother, and also their many slaves. You can trade pretty much anything. Like, people over here are trading Bitcoin and gold, and there's so much gold and Bitcoin trading over in this part that there's actually a special police car. So now, after the hectic Grand Bazaar, we are at the Süleymaniye Mosque, a 16th century mosque that has gardens and a terrace overlooking the Golden Horn. You might have noticed that the dome and minaret shape is pretty similar to the Hagia Sophia. took the ferry to the Asian side. We're in Kadikoy. And look at this amazing Christmas display. And it's Boxing Day right now, 26th of December. And it looks like an amazing dessert shop, so I think we'll try it. There's a really cool market on the Asian side. It's raining pretty heavily, but the stalls are pretty nice. Kind of like the Spice Bazaar or the Grand Bazaar, except it's not as good.
Decided to visit one last mosque, the Blue Mosque.